The leader of the National Unity Platform Party has urged party members, especially his foot soldiers, to consistently demonstrate a strong sense of discipline to prevent any provocation of security forces. Robert Kyagulanyi, commonly known as Bobi Wine, added that this approach is essential for both their safety, individual reputation, and that of the party. Kyagulanyi made the remarks today while addressing journalists at his residence in Magere, Wakiso district, regarding the incidents that occurred on Tuesday when he reportedly sustained injuries from a tear gas canister.
Tugenda kukuba abo abasirikale mu mboga za mateeka.
In recounting the events that occurred on the day, singer turned politician Kyagulanyi asserted that he was struck by a tear gas canister.
Najayo pistol na icha mukisa mulungi nti nabadde ne bannange babiri nga balina kamera nga bazimutuluzamu etole motoka yaffe n'akwata akakebe kati ya gasi n'akatusindiki n'akatukasukira akakebe ako ne kantulikira okugulu.
Kyagulanyi added that the party has initiated a process to ensure that all officers involved in the Bulindo incident are held accountable under the law as individuals. The Minister of Health, Dr. Ruth Acheng, has said there is no cause of alarm over the 10 mpox virus cases that have so far been recorded across the country. Acheng made the remarks while providing a comprehensive update on the status of mpox in Uganda. She stressed that the Ministry of Health is in full control of the situation.
There is nothing to be worried about. Everything is under control. And that is why I stated very clearly in my statement that there is no restriction to travel, to trade, to tourism. And there will be no lockdowns. Because this is a preventable disease, it is manageable. And we can all manage it together.
The districts of Kasese and Mayuge recorded 3 cases each, Kampala 2, while Wakiso and Amuru districts recorded 1 each. Yesterday, the first shipment of vaccines against mpox donated by the European Union arrived in DRC, the epicenter of the epidemic. Mpox is a contagious virus that can cause painful skin lesions and has already killed at least 450 people during an initial outbreak in DR Congo, which has declared this outbreak in parts of Africa a public health emergency of international concern. At least 17 children were killed in a fire that ripped through the primary school dormitory in central Kenya last night, with initial reports indicating it was overcrowded in breach of safety standards. The blaze in Hillside and Arasha Academy in Nyeri County broke out at around midnight, engulfing rooms where more than 150 children were sleeping. The police said the average age of the victims was around 9 years. According to the National Police spokesperson Rezila Onyango, there are 17 fatalities and 16 others were taken to the hospital with serious injuries. She added that the bodies recovered at the scene were burnt beyond recognition. Kenya's Citizen TV showed images of what appeared to be the aftermath of the blaze, with blackened corrugated iron roofing that had collapsed on itself. The cause of the fire was not yet known, but Kenya's National Gender and Equality Commission said initial reports indicated that the dormitory was overcrowded in violation of safety standards and called for an immediate inquiry.
The country has woken up this morning to very devastating news from this county. We have lost some children. Therefore, at the outset, the government of Kenya sends the deepest sympathies and condolences to the families whose children have lost their lives or have been injured as a result of the fire.
President William Ruto, currently in Beijing for China Africa Summit, expressed his condolences in a post on X. He said, "Our thoughts are with families of the children who have lost their lives in the fire tragedy. This is devastating news." Ruto instructed officials to thoroughly investigate this horrific incident and promised that those responsible will be held to account. The school, which caters for about 800 pupils, is located in a semi-rural area around 170 kilometers north of the capital, Nairobi. Around 100 parents were gathered outside the gates of the school, anxiously waiting for updates on their children. The dormitory was sealed off by yellow police tape with officers stationed at all access points.